We're going to do a case illustrating Faraday's principle. I'm going to do a case where it's kind of an unusual one. You have a rod pivoted about a certain point. Let's say the rod is 2 meters long, and the rod is rotating, let's say, clockwise at a rate of 4 radians per second. And then there's a magnetic field coming out of the board, permeating this whole region, okay? So this whole region, and then let's say the magnetic field is equal to 2 milliteslas. And then the problem will say something like, what is the EMF produced at the two ends of the rod? What is the EMF? N d phi b dt. N is 1 in this case, there's no number of loops, okay? And then you have d phi b dt, you have, in this case, the magnetic field is not changing, it's constant. So you have b, and then you have da dt, okay? So the area is changing. Now, in what sense is the area changing here? Well, what's happening here is that this thing is sweeping out a certain area. So imagine a disk here. It's sweeping out a certain area in a certain time interval. So essentially what we need, the information that we need here, is the total area that it sweeps out divided by the time that it takes to sweep out that area, right? So that's the area. The area is going to be the total area, so it's going to be pi times r squared over the total time, okay? Now, what's the b? B is coming out of the board. So it's 2 milliteslas, and out of the board is positive, right? So it's gonna be 2 × 10⁻³, pi, the radius of the circle is 2 meters, okay? in reality, we should even be, look at this a little bit more detailed. We should do, the flux is B dotted into dA, right? It's coming from there, okay? So before you even can take the B out, imagine the B dA. Now, which direction is dA, okay? dA is the area vector. Which direction is that? So if you go like this, since it's rotating clockwise, okay? Since it's rotating clockwise, the area vector is into the board. You see? So the area vector is into the board. The magnetic field is out of the board. So you really should have here B dotted into dA. It's going to give you B dA cosine of 180, because the B is out of the board, the area is into the board. So cosine 180 is going to be negative 1. That negative 1 is going to make this negative positive. So you really should have a positive here. Okay? So you have positive, and then you have B, and then A. So then what happens, B, since it's uniform over the area, the B comes out of the integral, and since it's uniform over time, the B comes out of the time. So it comes out of the integral, and then comes out of the time, and then it goes out here. So then you're left with just D, and then integral of dA is A, so you get dA dt. And then that's equal to the surface area that it swept. So area divided by the time, okay? So now let's get back to here. So now I have positive. So 2 × 10⁻³, pi times 2 squared. What's the time? How many seconds is it gonna take? Well, if it's going 4 radians per second, that's the omega, right? We know period is equal to 1 over frequency, and so we have omega is equal to 2 pi f, and f is equal to omega over 2 pi. So period is equal to 2 pi over omega. In other words, 2 pi radians divided by 4 radians per second. In terms of units, that's how that's going to be working up. You have 2 pi radians, that's how many radians is a complete circle, divided by the rate of rotation, 4 radians per second. So that one cancels, and then this one cancels with this, you have 2. So it's equal to pi over 2 seconds. That's the period of the oscillation. It's going to take that much time to oscillate once. So then you take that pi over 2, put it into here. Okay? So then the pi cancel. And you get basically 2 cubed. This 2 goes to the top. So 2 cubed is 8. 8 times 2 is 16. So you see, 8 times 2 is 16. And then 10 to the minus 3 is a milli. 16 millivolts. Okay, so you have 16 millivolts is produced between the two ends of the rod. Okay, now if we want to ask the question, which direction is the current flowing in the rod? There's going to be a current flowing in the rod. Which direction is current going to be flowing in the rod, and which part of the rod has the higher voltage? Okay, let's make a certain argument, and let's see here what's going to happen. Okay, if this side has a higher voltage and this side has a lower, let's say this has a 0 volts, current will tend to move in which direction? Positive current always flows from higher voltage to lower voltage, right? Current will flow in this direction. Let's use a blue here. Current will flow in this direction from higher voltage to lower voltage, right? So what's going to happen? There's going to be a force on the rod due to the B field, right? What's the force? Force equals IL crossed into B, right? So you have the B field is coming out of the board, okay? And then you have the current flowing this way. So you have this way, the force is this way, right? That doesn't make sense, because if that was the case, then it's going to start spinning faster, right? The rod was already spinning clockwise, right? So the magnetic field should try to fight against that, right? So that means the current should flow the other way. That means this side should be at a higher voltage. This side should be at a lower voltage, the center. The current should flow this way. Now what's the direction of the force? Like this, okay? Like this, down. Okay, that means the magnetic field tries to prevent and fight against the direction that the rod is spinning, okay? All sides of the rod have a force on it like this, down. And it tries to fight against that. So that means this side of the rod has a higher voltage, this side has a lower voltage. So if we call this 0 volts, the end of the rod is going to have a voltage of 16 millivolts. 16 millivolts, right? And if for some reason the problem gave us what is the resistance of the rod, let's say it was 10 ohms, how much current is going to flow in the rod? Well, 16 over that, 1.6 milliamps. The current is V over R, 16 millivolts over 10, 1.6 milliamps. Kind of an unusual problem, right? But a very, very good demonstration of Faraday's principle. Thank you.